name is Dr. Sasha. I'm a dental surgeon, but my true passion is cars. I own a couple of Brugge Mopedas. What is a Mopeda? It's by far one of the rarest microcars. Out of 14 produced in the 1950s, only 5 surviving, and to own 2 is quite a privilege. Egon Brugge, who built the Mopeda, understood that the future is in the small cars. He curved this little beauty and drove to the car fair, where it had tremendous interest. The Opel company approached him, offering to build, I think, 140,000 of them. Only after printing all those catalogs for this car, the management or the advocates told, "Guys, are you crazy? We're in the 50s. People like the big fins on cars and the big engines. We'll drive a tiny car." And they canceled the deal, and that's how only 14 cars were made. I live in Israel, and the first one I found was online, actually. A friend of mine, Ferdy, owned it in Germany. I saw a photo of it and had to ask him, can I come and see it? Just see it. A few emails back and forth, and he agreed to see me at his place. And the moment I saw it, I was in shock. I told him, Ferdy, I must sit in one. And he allowed me. And then I said, Ferdy, I must start it. And it was pouring rain, and he said, what are you, crazy? And I answered, Ferdy, a fool from a different continent. Sure I'm crazy, let's start it. Took around the street, and I just had to have it. The second one I found was owned by a collector named Malcolm. He passed away, and only then, after tens of years of ownership, his family agreed to sell it. Actually, the second one is the most important and the most original Mopeda in the world. It's completely unrestored. It drives beautifully. You pull the cable, you start it, and start spreading smiles around. In my profession, I work with smiles every day. I transfer them by veneers or surgery. But trust me, driving a Mopeda is by far more smile transforming than anything I do on a daily basis. And I insist on driving it. I just like to park it outside of a restaurant and share it with the world. I think that's what really rare cars have to be. They need to be seen, they need to be admired, and to generate the interest in the next generation. I love the fact that it's challenging to drive. It's handlebar operated, very similar to a bike. There is no speed gauge. It goes like 30 miles per hour, and it's fast enough, scary enough. It's by far more exciting than going 10 times of that in a sports car. My son Noam loves it. He grew up with the engine in the living room. He was playing with it even before he was playing with his tiny cars. So yeah, it's a family car, our tiny family car. You know what, I came to think that I don't really need two, and I think it's not fair to own 2 out of 5 surviving cars. So actually, next month, February 6th, RM Auctions are putting this little baby of ours, the unrestored, the rare one, as one of the stars of the biggest auction they do during the Retromobile weekend. So you'll have the chance to own it and smile as much as I do.